my friends. It's your old pal, Jordan the Lion, coming to you from Nashville, Tennessee. Even though it's sprinkling out once again today, we're going to try and find some of our favorites here at Woodlawn Roche Patton Cemetery. Days with Jordan the Lion begins now. Alabama was showing me no love letting up on the rain, and it doesn't look like Tennessee's going to either on this trip. Mausoleum time. All right, I know there's quite a few here. The downside is usually they have a lot of maps that will help you find everybody very easily, but they didn't happen to have any this time. Well, the first one that I found on my own here is J.D. Sumner. J.D. Sumner was, I mean, a lot of people say he was like Elvis to Elvis. When Elvis was going to live shows when he was young, J.D. Sumner used to help sneak him in because J.D. was in a famous gospel group. And then Elvis eventually asked J.D. to be one of his backup singers on the road, and also sang at Elvis's mom's funeral. Sang at Elvis's funeral, as a matter of fact. J.D. Sumner. J.D., I believe, also holds the Guinness Book of World Record for the deepest bass voice. Pretty cool. He sang with Sunnyside Boys, Sunshine Boys, Blackwood Quartet, and J.D. Sumner and the Stamps. Now right over here is songwriter Katie Oslin, and she's famous for being not only in the Songwriters Hall of Fame, she's also in the Nashville Songwriters Hall of Fame, and she goes down history as being the first female songwriter to receive the Country Music Award Song of the Year. In 1988, she wrote a song called 80s Ladies. And then right up here, right next to her, the great Tammy Wynette. Many call her the first lady of country music. I don't think there's any dispute that that is the love of her life right there. He's also buried in this cemetery, but not here, because boy, did they have a fiery relationship. Tammy and George Jones, that was one for the record books. Tammy was a struggling singer and just had this absolutely incredible voice, and had kids and was married and met George Jones, and George fell in love with her, and when they were having an affair, and one night he just kicked the door in at her house, pointed a gun at her husband and said, "Tammy and I are in love and we're getting out of here." And Tammy took her and the kids, left everything else, and took off and went with George. And they had, like I said, some pretty tumultuous times, some knockdown, drag out fights, but I think everybody agrees they were each other's true love of their life. They just couldn't seem to make it work when George was drinking all the time. He was pretty bad back then. I remember one of the stories was that she afraid for her life and had to call and have the cops come out because he was shooting holes in, all over the house, and she was afraid he was going to go out drunk driving, so she hid all the keys for all the cars, so he got on the lawnmower and drove to the liquor store. Together again. It's really cool. There's so many family photos and everything out here. Some cemeteries, they don't allow you to actually put anything up here. They will remove that if you do it, but this one's really good about it. You can tell. Look at all the great photos from her life and her family. Talented lady, very talented lady. She had her beautician's license and used to do her own makeup and hair and stuff, and she was the only one that George would allow to do her hair for most of the time. He always trusted her. Rest in peace, Tammy. She ended up, when she passed away, she was actually living in the last home that Hank Williams and his wife lived in and owned. Then over here they have a guest register for friends and relatives of Casey and Liz Anderson. There's Liz Anderson. And there's Casey. Casey's got his hands full. And then they're both buried right here. Right there. And there's Lynn. Nice to see that their grandkids have been out here visiting, leaving little things for them. Pretty popular for her 70s song, I Never Promised You a Rose Garden, if you remember that one. She was named top female vocalist and female vocalist of the year for the CMA. Pretty great career. And then Casey was pretty interesting because he was actually in a world champion drill team group. He participated in as one of 1,000 riders in an original reenactment of the Pony Express ride that commemorated the first 100 years of the Postal Service. And he also co-wrote one of the first hits for Merle Haggard, I'm a Lonesome Fugitive. He was one of the founding members of the Nashville Songwriters Association. Now check this out, I also just wandered into Otis Blackwell Sr.'s grave. I actually wasn't looking for him and recognized the name because he wrote Return to Sender, Great Balls of Fire, All Shook Up. Some of those really early classic rock and roll songs that we know. Those are all thanks to Otis Blackwell. Also has a lot of family coming out here to visit him. It's really cool to see, I love that. These are all birthday cards for Otis. And then here's Ernie Ashworth. When we were in the Alabama Music Hall of Fame, remember we saw that cool suit that had like the lips all over it? That was Ernie Ashworth. That was his suit. He was a Decca recording artist, and he had hits such as Forever Gone, You Can't Pick a Rose in December, and Each Moment Spent with You. Also a member of the Grand Ole Opry. And one snappy dresser. Then here's a little Elvis tie-in. H. Gordon Stoker. He was one of the Jordanaires. And I think he was on that Ween album. The country album, Ween's 12 Golden Country Hits. I think he was doing backup on there. And they actually have a picture of him singing with Elvis right here. Pretty cool thing to be known for, the Jordanaires. What a brilliant vocal group. Also, one of the youngest members to ever perform at the Grand Ole Opry when he was 15. That reminds me, DJ Fontana's buried here. We'll have to see if we can find him before we leave. And then right over here's one of my favorites. This is a statue of Little Jimmy Dickens. Look at all the Christmas stuff they have up. I love it. And then that's Little Jimmy's grave. But a whole lot more here. Look at this. First off, you have Little Jimmy right there. Country superstar. Everybody loved Little Jimmy Dickens. He was a short little guy. If you ever saw String Bean, String Bean used to wear Little Jimmy's pants. There he is, WSM. That's Grand Ole Opry. So that's him performing at the Opry. And I believe, because I've been there, I'm trying to remember, they do have a statue of him in front of the Opry. There he is out fishing. There he and his wife, Mona. Beautiful moments there, holding hands. She's still living. Jimmy also used to wear all those rhinestone suits and nudie suits and everything. He was 4'11". He wasn't even 5 foot tall, but he used to do novelty songs. So one of his big hits was, "May the bird of paradise fly up your nose." They used to also call him Jimmy the Kid. And at the time of his death, he was the oldest living member of the Grand Ole Opry. And his daughter left him a Father's Day card. That's so cool. Now, right directly above Jimmy is Lily Mae Tomlin. She is, well, these are the parents of Richard Tomlin and Lily Tomlin. And Lily Mae Tomlin's best friend was Queen of the Gospel, Dottie Rambo, who is buried right here. Miss Joyce Reba Dottie Rambo. That was a surprising death. Talk about beloved. And then right above Dottie and right beside Lily and Guy Tomlin is going to be their son Richard Tomlin. Dottie Rambo. Absolutely, Queen of the Gospel. The note says, Dottie, our family adores you and your legacy of music. Thank you for living real and for letting the Holy Spirit rest on you. And this whole bouquet right here is left here for Lily Mae and Guy Tomlin. Has their pictures on there. A celebration of what would have been her 106th, or what was that? Yeah, no, 100th birthday. And mother of Lily Tomlin. And then I noticed just above Richard Tomlin and Michael Langston is Jim Ed Brown. He had a singing group with his sisters called the Browns. He was a member of the Grand Ole Opry and was a TV show host. I think he hosted that Nashville on the Road at one time. He's a member of the Country Music Hall of Fame. Died of lung cancer, unfortunately. Long battle with lung cancer. So then as we leave little Jimmy Dickens and Dottie Rambo, I see his daughter who had left the card. She's going to be up here, Lisa Dickens. Oh, and then I just realized right over here, Jerry R. Hubbard, Mr. Jerry Reed. Jerry Reed, so awesome, so awesome. One of the greatest musicians in Nashville history. He was one of Chet Atkins' session guys for back when they were releasing all those RCA recording in Studio B, making hit after hit. Jerry Reed was the guitar player that was always in there. Had a huge hit with his own music, Smokey and the Bandit. Gotta love Jerry Reed, man. I'm a big fan of him. So we just came from the mausoleum, which is that building right there. Come catty corner to this gated area, and there's a few people in here you'll want to stop and visit. The most notable one, the big man right there. Step right up and come on in. We've already talked about this guy a little bit. He stopped loving her today. Left a wreath upon the door. That's right. The Possum. I won't sing anymore because nobody can do George Jones justice, but wow, what a guy. Tremendous talent. I mean, I don't think that there was anybody in country music that would say there was anybody better than him at the time. He was the king. That time, he could do no wrong. He could sing no wrong. Even with all of his crazy antics when he wasn't performing, people loved him. It got to a point where you just didn't even know if he was gonna show up to shows. They said if they didn't have somebody watching him, he might just sneak out, hop in a car with some stranger and take off. They said his road manager one time went off looking for him and found two women sitting out on a on their porch. She goes, have you ladies seen George Jones? Yeah, he just stopped and had a drink with us. And we went down that way. And then he went down the road and found him at a hotel eating fried chicken. George was just a character. Just a character. But beneath it all, when he wasn't drinking or anything, very, very talented guy. And when he wasn't shooting at his friends for making him mad, he was a pretty generous guy too. In fact, one of his friends and another heavyweight in music is buried in this same section right here, this tour section, and it's because of George, because the man who's buried here, we'll take a look at in a second, he was in George's band at one time, went on to become a huge star, and then died penniless. Johnny Paycheck. So, even though most people believe that Tammy Wynette was the real love of his life, at the end of his life, he was not married to Tammy, so his wife at the end is pictured here with him. And then over here it says, George Glenn Jones was and is the king of broken hearts and struggles in a way that somehow lightened our own. His voice was effortless and unforgettable. He brought unsurpassed emotional eloquence to every song he sang. He was and is the soul of country music. No one will ever fill his shoes. He is at rest, but his music is alive and ageless. He gifted it to us all, to the joyful and the broken. Walk through the world with me, he sang, and we do. Look, the two flower pots even have the GJ. Yeah, there was a funny story that one night he showed up at Waylon Jennings' house and was drinking with Waylon, and they started arguing about something, and next thing you know, Waylon has to throw him out of the house, and George is out front carrying on and everything, and he's out there screaming, Waylon, I'm the greatest singer in country music. So Waylon went and got some rope, tied George to a tree, and said, here, you're going to let this one die off right here. You can sober up, and we'll untie you in the morning. He goes, I'm the greatest singer in country music, damn it. Waylon Jennings says, yep, and you're going to sleep right there on that tree. The greatest voice in country music. Good night, George. Close the door. Oh, wow. Now, I mentioned Johnny Paycheck. Johnny Paycheck is also over here. Right here. Not quite the same grandioso grave, but at least he has one. And this guy was awesome, too. Like I said, started out Ohio boy, started out in George Jones' band. He was the backup in the backup band. He was the bass player. And even George said, Johnny was just too, he was just too talented. He was too talented to stay in the back. He had the hit with, take this job and shove it. He also had his demons. He was another wild one. He used to get into fights and shoot people in bars and ended up in jail, hung out with the Hell's Angels. Guy just did it all. Did it all. Lived that old crazy country lifestyle you've always heard about. He was another epic one. And then I believe I'll have to look around. Actually, oh, right there. Rod Baronis. Football player Rod Baronis. I believe that's how you pronounce his name. I remember seeing him play. He was, you can see right there on the Tennessee Titans. Sadly, he died in a car accident. He was a great kicker. One of those people that, I think he even had a record for like the most good field goals or field goal attempts in a game. He was also, at the time of his death, married to Terry Bradshaw's daughter. Dream big and reach for the stars. The road to success is lined with many tempting parking spaces. And then you can see on the bench, it not only has his team logo, but it also has the number. And then down at the other end of the cemetery, most of this is completely empty. There's a few other people down here. So back in here, we have Billy Sherrill, who was a record producer and songwriter, and he was known for working with Tammy Wynette and George Jones. Co-wrote the hit Stand By Your Man. And he also had a song called The Most Beautiful Girl. And so his wife's down here says The Most Beautiful Girl. Songwriter, musician, producer, child of God. And then right beside Billy Sherrill, who's right there, you have Jerry Chestnut. U.S. National Songwriter of the Year 1972, International Songwriter of the Year 1973, Hall of Fame songwriter. Right up there says titles Trouble, Four in the Morning, Good Year for the Roses, Another Place, Another Time. That was a Jerry Lee Lewis hit. Holding On to Nothing, It's Midnight, Love's Coming Down, One of the Wonders You Perform. I love that song, It's Midnight. Saved by Grace, and then his wife over here, Patricia Chestnut. The Lord is my shepherd. So now we're leaving this section of the cemetery and we're going to the section across the street to the South Mausoleum. Hopefully he's in here. We're looking for one person in here. Yeah, so right here from this entrance, come in to the left side, go all the way down, and he's just to the left. Right here, from Elvis's first band, DJ Fontana, the drummer, with Scotty Moore and Bill Black, the beat behind the king, great DJ Fontana. Well, my friends, we're gonna call it a day. This rain has just, man, it just will not let up and take a break. So there are other people buried here like Marty Robbins and Red Foley and Webb Pierce, but we'll have to come back and see them another time. I hope you enjoyed all the people that we visited today. Thank you all for watching. From Nashville, Tennessee, we'll see you all next time. Have a great night and goodbye.